I'm Gordon. I'm one of the people behind Flutefling, and we're an organisation in Scotland, just a loose informal organisation. And we put on events and workshops and teaching opportunities here in Scotland to try and promote the flute and the whistle in Scottish traditional music. You can find out more about what we do at flutefling.scot, which is our website. This video is part of a project trying to get some common session repertoire together, and this is set number five. There are 10 sets, so there are 10 videos, and this is number five, which is slowing things down a little bit with a couple of modern compositions. And this is I've got Marnie Swanson of the Grey Coast, which is a kind of waltz written by Andy Thorburn as music that was part of a play. And the Grey Coast is up at Caithness, up right in the northeast of Scotland, right in the very north of Scotland, in fact. and Marnie Swanson is the character in the play. It's quite a common session tune. I wouldn't say it's overly common, but people know it and people recognise it. In a departure from the other videos, I'm not going to demonstrate playing it, just for copyright reasons. I've tried to get in touch with Andy, and who is a very talented keyboard player, plays in various lineups. And I'm trying to get in touch with him, and I can't do so at the moment. So just as a matter of courtesy, I'm not going to demonstrate that tune to you in this video. There's plenty of videos out there of other people playing it, and I suggest you go and have a look at them. It's a really nice one by Duncan Chisholm, and playing on the fiddle. And you can hear it's just very nice, sedate, sweet melody. It's a little bit unusual. It kind of stretches and contracts a little bit, and it's in 3/4 time, but it's not a conventional waltz, I would say, in my experience. I know people do try and play it like that, but it's not to my taste. Hey, you've just got to play with the people that you're playing with, you know, so I fit in with them. The second tune I have got permission for, it's by Calum Stewart. It's Looking at a Rainbow Through a Dirty Window, and Calum was in touch with me to say that he's re-recording it, and it's going to be on an album of his that he hopes to release this year, so we can look forward to that. Looking at a Rainbow Through a Dirty Window. I've got another video of this actually on my YouTube channel, because I played it during lockdown, at the beginning of lockdown. It's really nice. It's written for the flute, on the flute, and I think it's excellent. And Callum's one of the top flute players in Scotland, and I highly recommend looking at his recordings and going to see him if you can. There's a lot of stuff out there that he's produced, and highly recommend it. So I don't have too much to say about this in terms of technical things to look out for. There are some opportunities to do in Marnie Swanson, for example. Just for some decoration, if you don't already do this, lots of people do it, and it's often misunderstood, I think. Not everyone understands it. Here we go. So what I'm doing there, it's borrowed from piping, and it also comes from Baroque flute playing. So I'm here on the G, and instead of playing, we're doing and it's like a ghost trill. It's just subtly shifting the note. It's very big in piping, and it's very appropriate here. It was in Baroque flute playing. It was termed flattement, which I believe means flattering the note. And so just watch out for, there's different ways of doing it. You can do it one. That's got a stronger sound, maybe too strong there. But anyway, so have fun just trying those tunes out. They're just, they're really gorgeous. And as with all of these slow tunes, there's opportunities for expression, things like that. So so enjoy them. Okay, and see you on the next one. Bye for now. ¶¶